Japan was once a major semiconductor manufacturing country. They were well regarded across the world for their advanced technology, precision engineering, and high-quality semiconductor production. Japanese companies like NEC, Toshiba, Hitachi, Fujitsu, and Sony were leading the market producing memory chips, microprocessors, and other semiconductor components that were integral to consumer electronics, computing, and industrial applications. However, the story of how Japan became the leading semiconductor hub is all but history now. Many people know that Japan has fallen behind in key semiconductor sectors like foundry services or the memory chip business to companies like South Korea's Samsung or Taiwan's TSMC. But what if I tell you that even though Japan had lost its lead in these key sectors, they are actually still a major semiconductor manufacturing country? In fact, they aren't just one of the many leading players out there. Japan is actually integral to the entire semiconductor manufacturing supply chain. Without them, the global semiconductor industry would struggle to function. So, which industries are those? Well, to understand that, it is important for us to first understand how Japan's overall semiconductor manufacturing industry declined. When we say that Japan once dominated the global semiconductor industry, we mean that they dominated more than 50% of the global semiconductor market, which occurred in the late 1980s. For instance, in 1989, the worldwide semiconductor revenue ranking shows that 6 of the world's top 10 semiconductor companies in that year were Japanese. These were NEC, Toshiba, Hitachi, Fujitsu, Mitsubishi, and Matsushita. Surprisingly, there weren't even a single Korean nor a Taiwanese company on the list. Of course, the entire story would change afterwards, and if we were to adjust the data to the year 2020, we would see that no Japanese company would be on the list for the revenue ranking. They would be dominated by Korean and American firms. What caused this decline? Several factors converged. In the late 1980s, trade friction with the United States led to the 1986 U.S.-Japan Semiconductor Agreement, pressuring Japan to open its market and stop alleged dumping of memory chips. Around the same time, the Plaza Accord drove up the yen's value, making Japanese exports more expensive. Meanwhile, South Korean firms like Samsung and SK Hynix, backed by state support, rose to dominance in memory chips, and Taiwan developed a new foundry model, led by TSMC, that Japan was slow to adopt. The PC boom of the 1990s and the smartphone revolution of the 2000s benefited companies in the US, Taiwan, and Korea. Japan's firms failed to fully capitalize on these waves. Many Japanese chip producers struggled to transition from the integrated device manufacturer model to the fabless foundry model and missed out on logic chip leadership and fabless design innovation. By the 2010s, iconic Japanese semiconductor divisions had consolidated or exited. For example, Elpida, Japan's last DRAM maker, went bankrupt and was acquired by Micron. And Toshiba's flash memory unit was spun off as Kioxia. Despite this erosion of market share, Japan did not vanish from the semiconductor scene. Instead, Japanese strengths shifted to other parts of the value chain. Even as its device makers lost ground, Japan nurtured a formidable ecosystem in semiconductor materials and production equipment. The country's focus on precision manufacturing and incremental innovation found a home in supplying the picks and shovels of the chip boom, the silicon wafers, chemicals, and machinery that all chip fabs rely on. This strategy, partly by necessity, has kept Japan indispensable in chip making, albeit behind the scenes. As we'll see, Japan today holds outsized shares in crucial segments of the industry, even while its share of finished chip output remains modest. One of Japan's greatest contributions to the semiconductor industry is in the materials required to manufacture chips. This includes raw silicon wafers, photoresists, specialty chemicals and gases, lead frames, packaging substrates, and other consumables. Japanese companies are global leaders in many of these areas, a legacy of decades of R&D in chemistry and materials science, and close partnerships with semiconductor manufacturers. By the numbers, we can graph out the materials in the semiconductor sector by market share. Here you can see that Japan isn't just a small player in semiconductor materials, they account for more than 52% of the global market share. That's no small figure, and it showcases how dominant Japan-based suppliers are in critical inputs. For example, Japan is the primary source of silicon wafers, the disks of pure silicon on which circuits are built. The two largest wafer manufacturers globally, Shin-Etsu Chemical and Sumco, are Japanese. Together they hold about 60% of the global silicon wafer market. This means that 6 out of every 10 wafers used in chip fabs worldwide come from just these two Japanese companies. In fact, nearly 90% of all semiconductor-grade silicon wafers are supplied by just 5 firms worldwide, and 2 of those, providing roughly half the world's wafers, are Japanese. Japan also dominates photoresists, the light-sensitive polymers used to imprint circuit patterns on wafers. Japanese chemical companies pioneered photoresist technology decades ago, and today a handful of them, such as JSR, Tokyo Oka Kogyo, TOK, Shin-Etsu, and Fujifilm Electronic Materials, command a large share of the market. Approximately 75% of high-end photoresists for advanced chip fabrication come from Japanese suppliers, including virtually all the cutting-edge resists needed for extreme ultraviolet, EUV, lithography. Even for older generation resists, Japan's share is significant. By one estimate, about 50% of the global photoresist market is supplied by Japanese firms. Other materials and components tell a similar story. Japanese firms lead in photomask blanks and mask-making equipment, essential for making the stencils that lithography uses. For instance, two Japanese companies, JEOL and New Flare, have a 91% share in the global market for EUV photomask production tools. In wet chemicals, solvents, acids, etchants, and gases used in chip etching and deposition, Japan's ultra-pure chemical producers are among the top suppliers globally. Niche materials needed for emerging technologies, like those for 3D chip packaging, are also a focus. Japanese companies such as Nissan Chemical and Showa Denko are investing heavily to develop adhesives and insulators for 3D chip stacking. Crucially, many of these material segments are not just areas of strength, but areas of near monopoly for Japan. A recent analysis noted that Japanese companies provide at least 50% of the world's supply in 14 out of the 19 most critical semiconductor materials. In some cases, the concentration is extreme. For example, fluorinated polyimide, used in chip fabrication and display panels, and certain high-purity chemicals have almost no substitutes outside Japan. This dominance became evident during a geopolitical spat in 2019, when Japan imposed export controls on 3 vital chip-making materials to South Korea. At that time, South Korea depended on Japan for 94% of its fluorinated polyimide, 92% of its photoresist, and 44% of its high-purity hydrogen fluoride imports. The move threatened to disrupt Korean memory chip production, underscoring Japan's leverage in materials. South Korea scrambled to find alternatives and diversify suppliers, an effort still ongoing. Now, even though Japan does not hold such a market share in other sectors, they also hold some kind of share in one way or another. To put this into perspective, let's pull up the graph on the semiconductor equipment market share. Here, you can see that even though they don't hold a monopoly on the sector, they still hold over 29%. For context, the leader here in the Japanese company list is Tokyo Electron, TEL, which stands as one of the top equipment companies globally. TEL is the world's 4th largest semiconductor equipment maker by revenue, after Applied Materials, ASML, and Lam Research. Likewise, if we take a look at the semiconductor upstream design, we get to see that Japan has a 6% share, which is higher than mainland China. Semiconductor upstream design is essential because they lay the foundation for how chips function. This includes designing the architecture, logic circuits, and integrated systems that power everything from smartphones to data centers. Another important one is midstream manufacturing, which is about producing the actual semiconductor chips based on upstream designs. This involves complex fabrication processes that require cutting-edge technology, precision engineering, and advanced materials. Here you can see that while Taiwan holds the lead, Japan was still able to capture a 7.5% share, which is more than China. So, as you can see, while Japan is no longer the leader in semiconductor fabrication, it remains an indispensable player in the global semiconductor industry. Its dominance in materials, equipment, and specialized chip manufacturing ensures that Japan continues to influence the sector despite the rise of competitors like Taiwan, South Korea, and the US. But anyway, do let us know what you think. Thanks for watching.